everybody. It's 5 o'clock on the East Coast, and this is The 5. I'm Eric Bolling, along with Andrea Tenteros, Leslie Marshall, Dana Perino, and Greg Gutfeld. We've got a lot to cover tonight. First, brand new details on the Solyndra scandal. Reports now show President Obama was warned about the company's finances last year before the loans were issued. Plus, is he in or is he out? The latest 2012 rumors on whether or not Governor Chris Christie is considering a presidential run. And major developments in the fight to repeal Obamacare. Now it looks like the Supreme Court will decide. We have all those details and much more. The 5 starts right now. We're starting tonight with developments on 2 major stories we've been covering right here on The 5. We'll get to Solyndra in a minute, but first, the latest on the Obama administration's botched Fast and Furious operation. Documents obtained by Fox News show that the federal government did in fact use taxpayer dollars to buy guns and knowingly sell those guns to Mexican drug cartels. And where are those guns now? We know some were used in the murders of U.S. border agents Brian Terry and Jaime Zapata. Bottom line, Leslie Marshall, the ATF botched the program. But this new information suggests the White House knew of the failing program all along.
Okay, my first voyage on the 5, okay?
Yep, we gave you a tough one.
Where's my white flag? I got to say, bad idea, botched, and a dud. And because I'm sitting in for Bob, in homage to him.
Sometimes he
does. No, you can't do that. You'll have to play. You can't back
okay.
up. And
no,
whatever
no,
you do, don't put your feet on the table.
I won't do that. But you can't just blame the president, okay? You have to look at decisions that were made from the ATF. Everybody wants to blame Obama. I understand it's election year. Yes, they
were. That's how it works when you are in the White House and you're the president, and then it doesn't matter if people made decisions way down the line. You take the responsibility for it.
You do take the responsibility.
I still blame Vin Diesel. He made the movie. Yeah, if they make a movie on the Chronicles of Riddick, we're in really big trouble.
But, you know, a lot of times, Ange, it's the cover-up, not necessarily the mistake. Dana points out if they just said, look, we made a mistake, it was terrible, this wouldn't be such a big deal. Well, I mean, honestly, Brian Terry's family and Jaime Zapata's family, we're praying for you. We're sorry about what happened, but certainly wouldn't be pointing fingers at Eric Holder, President Obama, whether they should maybe even step down.
Yeah.
Holder's still
a huge deal, but you're right. The fact that they tried to duck on this one and really stonewalled. They stonewalled the press. Eric Holder won't talk. President Obama won't talk. They've totally ignored this. Makes this even worse. So, look, I mean, if you see the reports, we've been running them all day on the network. I mean, ATF agents were actually selling guns and then just watching them just fly away, and they'd call their supervisor and they'd say, can we go after them? And they would say denied each time. Why? Somebody needs to answer the question why they could not do what they were supposed to do, which was go after those guns and those drug cartel leaders.
Here was the big problem. There was no difference between a botched operation and a successful operation. The botched one, you lost track of the guns. In a successful one, criminals got the guns.
Right.
There was absolutely no end game that was a win. But the thing that bugs me the most about this is that the attorney general seems, I guess, more comfortable with criminals getting guns than law-abiding citizens. He seems to have more of a hang-up with gun stores than he does this problem.
Take a listen to the tapes that they've uncovered. Listen to these people, ATF agents, talking about the program right now. Clearly, they knew what was going on. Listen to this.
Remember the guns you gave him?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was Dodson.
Oh, I know.
He purchased firearms
mm-hmm.
as a straw purchaser and gave him the bad guy. That was Don Dodson.
This goes back. So when this first all started, one of the things I said, just from based on my experience in the working in communications and politics and in an administration, you don't know all that went on. Nobody's memories are perfect. The first thing that they should have done is said, we want an investigation and we want it now. And then every other question that comes, you say there's an investigation and we're cooperating with it. Instead, they have this no drama Obama type of attitude where they just shrug their shoulders, and then little by little things like this start coming up. In law enforcement, there's a saying that you let money walk, you never let weapons walk, but that's what happened in this situation.
Sure, and Darrell Issa at one point, he's a congressman investigating this, said there were maybe 2,000, maybe 2,500 guns that were sold to drug cartels, and they said they followed one gun for a half a day.
No, I this is everything we're going to talk about tonight. This is the only, I'm going to say I agree with you. And Dana, I agree with you as well. Even though I didn't work for a president, mm-hmm. you know, I would say you have to own it. You know, you have to own it. There's an investigation. Find out all the information. Mm-hmm. Or like you said, Andrea, you don't just
and don't
not say anything. This, I know that my fellow libs out there are going to be like, Leslie, what are you doing? You've been sitting with those four people for a few minutes.
Not necessarily. You have to argue on the merits. And the merits of this thing stink. And the other thing that they have done is because most of the media has given them a pass on it, they think that it's a partisan thing. It's not. Mm-hmm. I don't know what the political affiliation was of the two border agents who were murdered with weapons that apparently were from this program, but I think we should all agree as Americans, let's figure out what happened and then work together to make sure it doesn't happen again.
And there's a bigger theme here, which we're going to talk about all these other topics throughout the show, but the government, really, can we trust them if they can't handle the guns? Now they're going to take over the health care? If isn't it a gun disappearing, what's going to be next? My liver? I'm on the operating table?
Where'd it go?
The ATF's going to take your liver.
I'll tell you what's next.
No, the doctors will.
And what's next is the other botched operation. This is the Cylinder scandal. Just very quickly, I'm going to run through this. December 2006, the solar company Cylinder applies for a Bush Energy Department loan that was placed on hold. 2008, very important, Fitch, the rating agency, rates Cylinder a B+, which is less than investment grade. March of 2009, about a year later, Obama Energy Department awards Cylinder $535 million of taxpayer money. 2010, 1 year later, Pricewaterhouse warns the administration about Cylinder's business model, says it could fail. 2 months after that, Mr. Obama, right there, you're looking at it right there, at Cylinder, shaking hands, calling Cylinder a symbol of progress. And then 1 year later, August, Cylinder shuts doors, lays off, Dana, 1,100 people, and taxpayer lose $535 million.
It's like when you, back in the dating days, when you're like dating a guy and you think, he's going to be the one. I want him to be the one. I'm going to just like pretend that he's the one. And then all of a sudden you find, oh, God, no, he's a jerk all along.
I've been there.
I know. I didn't want to mention it. they have a problem with Cylinder as well. And it's the same one that they have with Fast and Furious, which is they brush it off. This is no big deal. And then little by little, you start pulling on the threads of this story and you find out the career civil servant said this deal was not ready for prime time. They said, the West Wing is pressuring us. We don't think this is ready for prime time. Don't make us do this. And they did it anyway. And then even when they found out that the company was not going to succeed, I mean, you can't make a product for $6 and sell it for $3 and expect to make a profit for a technology that wasn't necessary in the solar energy world. The White House, believe me, last week you saw Cylinder executives raising their right hand and then pleading the fifth. Somebody else in the administration will be raising their right hand before the end of this.
This is very important. The rating agency in 2008, Fitch, calls it not investment grade. Within months, Obama offers the $535 million. In March of 2010, Pricewaterhouse, another rating agency, says, there's a problem here, administration. And guess what happens? 2 months later, Mr. Obama goes and does a photo op at Cylinder. I mean, is this crony capitalism or outright blatant corruption?
Or incompetence.
This is not cronyism on behalf of the White House. There is an investigation going on, and you have $38 billion that were spent on various programs, 40 of them to be exact. 39 of them are a success. 39 of them have created jobs. One, Cylinder, yes, a mistake of an investment, no question.
No, but it's different. A technology that fails is not the same as funneling taxpayer dollars to a company to benefit the investors before the taxpayers.
Right.
That's the investigation.
Right.
40 investigation
companies. None of 40
exactly.
Companies.
The investigation 40. Is about
right. Not one.
Special favors.
Did the Obama donor get preferential treatment in bankruptcy court? That is the biggest
That's
issue
right.
here, because I've said it before. Where's really the scandal? Okay, yes, the president incompetent. If they warned him about this, that is incompetence, maybe not a crime. But if you go on the White House website, they talk about doing this exact thing, using taxpayer dollars to subsidize and fund industries that they feel are important to their base.
This isn't a scandal.
This is Obama, everybody.
Does it not bother you that the company got $535 million and turns out one of Mr. Obama's major bundlers happened to be, through one of his many investment vehicles, happens to be the biggest shareholder of Cylindra? Yeah.
There's a lot of things that bother me about Cylindra tonight at 9.
Including the name of the company.
The fact is, if investors don't want to invest in a technology, that's a pretty good sign that it's not a good investment. And when the government is interested in it, that means it's a technology that needs to be propped up. But I want to make a point also about environmentalism in general. Environmentalists, as a rule, dress like kids. They dress like teenagers at fat camp, and that's because they think like children. And thinking like kids allows you to make these mistakes. Whenever you're talking about green causes, you suspend common sense, and you don't look at the bottom line, and you make these horrendous mistakes, especially when it's not your money.
And what you're wearing.
Yes, exactly. Gotcha.
All right, coming up a few weeks ago, we discussed this notion that White House voters who aren't backing President Obama in the election are considered racist by the left. Well, now we may have proof, and Greg will give us those details next on The 5. Also, don't forget to email us at the5@foxnews.com.
Nice song.